Sorry, miss. I didn't even notice. You're right.
Here's your debarkation card. You're in transit, aren't you? You'll have to fill it out for customs. Oh, Japanese. Is it hard?
I don't know yet. I began reading at London Airport. Promised myself I'd have finished it when we got to Japan. But we're landing early at Bombay.
This is wrong.
What? Well, you're going with us all the way to Japan, aren't you?
No, the entire crew changes so...
Oh, just my luck.
Well, hold on a minute. There's been a storm in North Africa. This one won't be on the plane.
Right.
Oh, miss, excuse me. Those letters on your cap, they've got to mean something.
International transport. Did you want something?
I still do.
Mr. Steele.
Yes?
Mr. George Steele.
Huh?
Mr. Steele, please. I have an urgent message.
Thank you.
You know what the RIU is, Mr. Steele?
Something about international uranium research, isn't it?
That's right. Now, we were informed by our friend, Mr. Simpson, of the State Department in Washington, that you'd be passing through here very soon. We've taken the liberty of calling you to make you a proposition.
I suppose it's something of great importance, like sending me on a mission to the moon.
Oh, actually, it is a little nearer than that, Mr. Steele, North Africa. The RIU seems to have found a large load of uranium.
But all our attempts to research the place have been blocked.
And yet there's no other claim on this load.
Several of our local technicians have disappeared.
At any rate, we should continue this discussion with a third act of the RIU. Our colleague from Switzerland, who is very well informed on the situation. I believe he is waiting for us now at the dispensary.
I feel much better. Thank you.
I would say that the women of today are wholly responsible for most of the illnesses of their men.
But on the other hand, you must admit that their presence stimulates our adrenaline, which in turn stimulates business. Thank you for accepting.
I'm sorry, he hasn't yet.
What do you mean, he hasn't yet? Aren't you interested in the Dark Continent, Mr. Steele? But apparently in North Africa, there exist survivors of the supposed lost continent of Atlantis. And they seem to have settled right on a rich load of uranium. As you know, locating uranium is our main object. And they've attacked the last two investigators we sent down.
I think what you need is a science fiction writer.
Very good, Mr. Steele, very good. You have the reputation of a man who is not easy to fool. And I agree with you. It strikes me as pure invention. I propose that the RIU abandon its search in North Africa. It's a little too adventurous. Very much too risky.
It's impossible to turn around now. Too many dollars and too many nations are already involved. If the RIU should retreat now, it would mean a serious loss in backing.
At any rate, I have the impression that Mr. Steele doesn't care to give up his very well-earned vacation.
And I like Tokyo.
He still has almost an hour to make his decision. We'll wait for him.
Goes on board. He's a cardinal.
Okay.
Be careful.
The weather's sort of changeable in North Africa. You work too much. Stop it. Let yourself relax.
I suppose you mean with you.
Sure. You can help me decide something by your answer. Are you free tonight?
Sure.
I accept.
So, you're giving up your vacation?
I suppose Tokyo can wait.
When you get down there, you will find another one of our agents waiting, who will collaborate with you.
Your assistant, in other words.
Our German associates insisted on it. We couldn't say no. The name is Bellermann.
We'll advise Bellermann of your arrival. You'll be met immediately.
Here is a breakdown of all you'll need to know about the RIU and what it's doing in North Africa.
A few details are missing. For instance, the office has been called several times lately by certain Nailavi. We think that he's very likely one of the band that attacked us.
He said on the telephone that he would be able to give us a great deal of information that would interest us.
Miss Nailavi, you know, seems to be disillusioned with the band he belongs to. He might prove to be very helpful.
We didn't want to see him in the office.
On this card is a telephone number he left us. It's a little hotel outside Rome. You decide whether it's worth the trouble to follow it up.
There's an Alfa Romeo out in the parking lot. License number RIU-1280. It's yours as long as you need it.
Luckily, my two colleagues are very thorough. As far as I'm concerned, I don't think a few days of rest would hurt. I might just take that little vacation you were giving up.
Tokyo?
No, that's a little too far for me. But I'll try San Moritz.
Wish it were me.
Please excuse me. This is our only possible means of contact. You find the receiver under the dashboard.
You can bring it closer. It's attached magnetically.
You can speak to me through it.
Now speak up the microphone.
Coming through?
Loud and clear.
My name is Nailavi. For days, I've been trying to get in contact with the RIU. With no luck. You can do a lot for me. And I can be quite helpful to you. Understand?
Go on.
I'm continually being trailed. I cannot come close to you. To speak to you. However, there is a certain person. Please. Please go where I direct you. Take the first right, then straight ahead. To the city. At the curve stop.
You all alone?
Tell her to get in.
take me away. Call me Malvina. You're the only man that can save us.
What?
My life is in danger. He loves me, Mr. Steele. And we need a lot of cash. And I bethought that the work he was doing was for a scientific society, honest and above board. Instead, he found out he was with a gang of criminals who worked against the RIU. But it was too late. Will you go there?
Where is it?
Oh, Tim, just a few miles outside of Rome. Nailavi will tell you all he knows, even the chief's name.
Mr. Nailavi, please.
Mr. Steele, I'll show you.
Letter B, and he crossed it out himself. A B. Huh. Who do you know whose name starts with a B?
No one.
A park. A hotel. Maybe he was trying to indicate some sort of place. Do you think the message was meant for you?
No. But his brother Yusuf just arrived in Rome today.
Okay, get out of here. But get in touch. I'll be at the RIU office. Go on. What are you doing here?
Oh, I always stay here when I'm in Rome. And you?
I'm going to call the police. I found the cadaver.
You can call from my room.
Yes, I was the first to see it. Thank you. Thanks a lot, Inspector. George Steele, S-T-E-E-L.
We will be right over.
What's your name?
What's it matter?
Police are always there when you don't want them. The register should tell us who was in this room.
My friend, that room has been vacant for several weeks. You are American?
Yes.
Prove it. You could have told me before that your profession was writer of mystery stories. Take this and watch that imagination.
Thank
Come on.
You. You intend to register in this hotel, sir?
Absolutely.
Continue the work of my brother Nailavi. Nailavi and all of us rebelled against Benullah. We've set up our own operations in North Africa.
Who's Benullah?
The head of the gang that's trying to get the RIU out of the picture. He's in Africa. He sent me word to come down. He wants to question me, but I've warned my friends they'll be able to take care of me when I get down. But first, I want to avenge my brother.
Do they know you're down there?
Neither in North Africa nor in Rome. I just came in today from Hamburg.
Today? I'll take your place.
That's not a bad offer. But I warn you, this is one trip you won't enjoy.
I know.
Follow me in your car. The B on my brother's hand stands for Bull, Bull. He was warning me not to go there.
Take the car back to RIU tomorrow.
And stay away from the hotel you are at. It belongs to the organization of Benullah.
Io vagamente speravo. Che tu guardassi me, confusamente sentivo che eri venuto per me. Io
us here. We will open it only on your orders.
Now that Youssef has finally arrived, we will be able to solidify our plans to attack and destroy the Nula.
And we will replace him.
Nailavi is dead, so now you, his valorous brother, assume the leadership. How do you think we can start our attack on Ben Ula? What plans do you have?
That's not Nailavi's brother. I knew Youssef several years ago, and that's not him. He's a spy.
Thank you.
aim for the gas tank and make it work.
You're pretty clever. What's your name?
Fatma.
I haven't thanked you yet. I think I should thank you again.
Well, they warned me that George Steele doesn't go in for formalities.
You know my name.
Through the RIU.
The RIU?
Cipher code 354. Go on.
280. 689. But you're Bellavan.
Yes, but how did you manage to guess? Now, you may kiss me, George, but with respect. I guess you really worked for that reputation.
Who is Ben Ola?
He wants to get the RIU out of Africa. He's the one who kidnapped Reich using the system with the trunks. Reich has turned out very useful.
And the second band? The one with Yusuf. How much do they know?
Not much at all.
Where is Ben Ola?
The Polynesian abandoned a fortress they had near the mountains. He took it over. Remember your Yusef when I take you there. Ben Ola wants to question him.
Thanks. That was very kind.
Anytime.
Keep down. I have three horses waiting down in the village. Hurry.
Why horses? Couldn't you find anything better?
Why?
It's impossible. I can't bear horses. You know that.
Don't be afraid. I'll ride next to you. Is that the fort?
Yes. To look at it, you'd think it was still abandoned. But behind that mountain, there's uranium. And Ben Ula's men keep it under heavy guard day and night. It's quite something inside. No one would think there'd be a laboratory in a fort. An experimental laboratory with all the most modern equipment. This is where the RIU was turned back. Ben Ula took possession of years of research by the RIU scientists and went ahead on his own. By his side, he has the famous scientist Gunter Reich and others, all fanatics. Ben Ula wants to get to those mountains, but it's not too easy. There's a curse. They say the survivors of Atlantis are there. Reich and Ben Ula believe it,
However, someone really is there, but no one's been able to contact them.
Fatma's here.
Good. Did you bring him?
Yes.
Fritz, let's have a look at him.
But he's not Yusef.
I know. That's what we expected. Don't worry, Fatma. This a bullet?
Yes. That's right.
How'd you get it?
A Japanese who didn't shoot too well.
Here, watch carefully. The analysis of the spectrograph is the most accurate. Do you see this black line? It is what we are looking for, uranium. But even more than uranium, a substance as yet unknown, an immensely powerful destructive force. Take a look at the reactions on the graph. That's the curse. The black and terrible curse that protects Atlantis. Yes, they might very well be the direct descendants of the people of that race. A race which I, as a scientist, do believe existed many eons past. A beaten, lost people who found safety in those caverns only because of power of destruction in the material that surrounds them. It is infinitely more powerful than uranium. And for them, it is only a demon. But whoever possesses it shall own power that has no limit.
And we must take possession of it.
These mountains are the Tolustis, or the mountains of the devil, or Atlantis, if you prefer. The entire zone is surrounded by a magnetic force field of exceptional strength. There's no sign of life anywhere around it. Every chart of air navigation indicates to avoid this zone with the utmost of care.
What should I do with him?
Try and find out how he contacts the outside. Then kill him.
That would be unwise. We could make use of him.
Don't bother thinking. Just do what I tell you. Kill him.
It won't be easy. I don't advise trying. Let's talk. I realize that this pistol won't save my life, but it'll remind you that my death will mean yours, too. My friends would get here quickly.
What do you want from us?
To know everything. Not about you, I already know that. The deposits, Atlantis. Uranium.
You want to go there, eh? You might even want our help.
Why not? I'll keep an eye on him. It's a mistake to kill him. We'd have the RIU on our backs. If you don't hear from me, you know where he can be found. I brought him here, and I'll bring him back. Don't worry.
Go with him.
The last well, before the mountains. It's been bone dry like that for many years.
All right. It's a good site for our last base. looks like the safety line. Thoughtfully indicated by the bones of the people who didn't make it. Discouraging, right?
Yes. It seems that the curse of Atlantis isn't just a myth after all.
We just have to be careful.
Witchcraft?
Yes. And soon you'll be seeing an apparition come from the sky. Just two special outfits to get us through that magnetic force. There we go. When Fritz x-rayed me, he thought he found a bullet in my elbow. And actually, at one time it was. I put in his place a radio receiver transmitter, tiny but perfect. It's cushioned against any type of shock. Well, it'll take some time for our new wardrobe to get it.
Some precise interruptions have been occurring at regular intervals throughout the magnetic force field. In all probability, these signals are controlled at a distant pre-established center. Calculating the curvature of the field, the center of command should be found at this point, underground.
Get in contact with Fatma immediately. I have a message.
I have a message. Can you hear me? Over.
I hear you. Over.
We found out that the force field is interrupted regularly. The generating plant must be underground. We're waiting for your message.
The seeds of the heavens will sprout. Over.
Fatma has communicated exactly this message. The seeds of the heavens will sprout. The well-known George Steele is going to have a little surprise. He really trusts our little Fatma. Now all we have to do is to get rid of the other one, the real Balavan. Fatma's idea to take the place of the real Balavan was a masterpiece. I'm very sorry for poor Mr. Steele. It'll be the worst setback of his whole life to think you were friends. By living with the enemy. Fine touch. Miss Bellafin, I have the pleasure to inform you that your colleague, Mr. George Steele, is among us. And furthermore, is receiving all consideration due to him.
But you're mistaken. George Steele is in Japan. On vacation.
You'll probably be seeing him very soon, Bellavan.
But that message of Fatma's meant to take her away, not to murder her. I was there. She used the code that we established.
It does us no good to keep two Bellavans. The one we need is on the job. That's enough.
She is.
I think we should let them stay alive.
Very well. You're right. We must find out who they are and how that helicopter managed to locate them.
And who sent them here?
I think I can guess.
Don't be afraid. Your woman will not be harmed. Our chief's daughter wishes to speak to you. What you see is one marvel of Atlantis, a battery run continually and only on sun rays.
This is a great day for us. The daughter of our chief Solus, the man who holds life and death in his hands, will wed Azul, the man chosen to be her husband. Here is Albia. Peace-loving people. Tell that to the world of our brothers. A people wishing to live in peace with all, with the protection of Atlas. But leave us to ourselves, and provoke not the wrath of our gods.
Can help me. What are you thinking about? Is it Fatima? I understand. Don't worry, no one will harm her. Or is she someone more important than me? You must say it.
I have a score to settle with Fatma.
You are our guest. You are sacred. You come with me.
Get ready to attack. Fatma's signal should come very soon.
I'm ready to go with you. Put on the suit.
How did you get those?
It wasn't hard.
What did you do to her?
Didn't you have a score to settle with her?
Yes, but you didn't. You're not Balaban. I've known it from the start. You gave yourself away. Learn your subject better when you masquerade as someone else. Balaban loves horses more than anything. She even has a stable of thoroughbreds that she trains herself. She's won lots of prizes. Now please excuse me, young ladies. I've had to put you in a position where you couldn't get in the way. Bye.
Listen, Fatma. I don't care a bit that you're not Balaban. You know, I'm rather glad of it. Watch. I'll show you how we'll get out of here. I hope I'm not wrong in supposing that you'd like the chance to escape from here, naturally with him. Yes, don't worry. I don't want to kidnap him, but I do need his help just for a minute. I can get all three of us out of here. There's only one way of doing it without the suits. We can do it if you'll help. So will you do what I tell you to?
Yes. Very well.
Atlantis, with its peaceful and brotherly people. But you wanted to know a little bit more. You were far too curious, because when you leave, you'll be dead. But before we leave each other forever, I would like you to have the satisfaction of finding out what you came here to learn, even if this knowledge won't be of much use to you. Yes, Atlantis does not exist. It was a fable, to disguise even more fantastic truth. Look over there, Mr. Steele. The meteorite. A fragment of an asteroid, that's all. Once a planet that orbited between Jupiter and Mars. And then it exploded. It is composed of an unknown substance which we call rubidium. It has the power of destroying immediately anything which is found within the field of its radiation. In a few days, this meteorite will take off. On its way to China, my dear Steele, which will again become the single greatest power in the universe. And now it's your turn to reveal a secret to me before you die, a very small secret, compared to the one I told you, but one that does interest me.
That's right. Atlantis isn't Atlantis, and I'm not Albia. But neither am I what Professor Lee Chen, or Solis, seems to think. I'm telling you all this because you're coming with me. And Steele is coming with me, whether he wants to or not. In my country, you can even marry him if you feel like it. I, my dear Fatma, work for a country who is interested in seeing that China never takes possession of a weapon with the destructive power of rubidium. And so we must get out of here to tell my chiefs of staff the little prize is ready and that they should come and get it before the other ones come to carry it away.
I am going to extract that bullet, that ugly memento you got from the Japanese. Don't worry. It won't hurt. Rubidium has many diversified uses, even helpful ones, as you'll see.
This is the control room. It is here that we regulate the field force surrounding us. Come here. This center controls the radiation. By throwing this switch, you turn it off.
Good.
If you turn these two handles, exactly 10 minutes from now, we'll be out with no trouble at all. And the others, leave that up to me. Call the fort now and tell them to come immediately.
Why?
It will help us to escape if Benula attacks.
And if Benula wins? He'll learn the secret of the rubidium.
If he wins. But don't worry too much about that. Just do what you're supposed to. Now, call the fort.
Fatma calling. Over.
Receiving you. Over.
I'm in Atlantis. Now listen carefully.
In a few minutes, I'm going to let down the field barrier. Attack immediately with every man. They're not prepared, but there's a lot of them. Quickly. I can't guarantee how long I'll be able to hold the barrier down.
Okay, we're leaving now. Over and out.
Know what to do?
I do.
I hope so, dear.
A pity I'm not able to give you a full demonstration of all the uses of rubidium we've discovered. The first radiation makes you insensible to pain. The second heals any wound immediately. The third The third you discover for yourself, it'll just be too late to understand it. You see? You are insensitive, but not invulnerable.
Stop it!
Don't touch that! It's dangerous!
I know. I'm not crazy. Thank you for preparing the meteorite. That was very kind. In a few days, we'll be here to take it.
I will kill you!
Who lifted the field. Come on, don't waste time. Force field back on, but Fatma's safe. Only you and I know the secret of Atlantis. There's a way of sinking the entire city under the desert so that no one will ever uncover it. Over here. Thank you.
Impossible. Ben Ula is one of the chiefs of the RIU. Nice to see you again. How's the weather in North Africa?
It's storming.
Well, sweetheart, I'm warning you. You've got to tell that sun to come out again. Otherwise, you're going to feel that hurricane all the way up here.
Listen, Rosie, if you want to get out, I'll give you the time. You just get my friends through customs. Those friends. With your system, there shouldn't be any trouble. Well, is the weather improving?
It's clearing.
Are you Mr. George Steele?
Yes.
I'm from the RIU. Three gentlemen are waiting to see you.
Thanks. Don't forget now. 5 minutes.
Wonderful job, Mr. Steele. Wonderful.
We owe you our deepest thanks.
Were you playing with fire?
No, snow burns as badly, and San Moritz had quite a bit of it. Congratulations, we'd like to hear your pull.
I can't tell you much. This thing is out of my hands, and I'm waiting for orders.
Not even a little tip?
Oh, I'd get burned.
Your car is outside, here's the key.
We'll all be very anxious to hear.
So will I.
All right, everything's ready.
You see how quickly the weather can change? This way.
It just could change.
Welcome to Rome. Sorry for the bumps, darling. Easy. There.
Oops.
Well, have a nice trip.
Well, first class is probably nicer. Is that Albia?
Listen, little girl, I don't need you to...
Oh, no, you certainly
quiet.
Don't.
Who is it?
Bell hot, sir.
Oh, good. Put him over there.
Thank you. Your key's in the envelope.
Right. Are you out of your mind?
I've never shared a man in my whole life.
Thank the Lord. Rosie's smarter than I thought she was.
My name is Rosie. Don't worry, you're among friends. You know you can't walk around in that comic opera costume. There's some clothes for you on the chair. I hope I got the right size. I was in such a hurry I couldn't find anything better. Maybe you'd like to know where you are. You're still in Rome, but outside the city in a quiet place. You have time to put on some makeup if you want to.
I'm not a spy. And I never was. When Ula was blackmailing my father, he forced me to pretend I was Bellavan. I didn't know anything about all this.
Well, gentlemen. So you never had any doubts about your colleague, huh? Well?
Doubts?
No. We all know your reputation, Mr. Steele, but you mustn't let yourself get carried away. Just who, then, is our friend?
Ben Ula. Yes, it seems impossible. I know. But he's the one who kidnapped Albie, and now I've got to find her. Let's go.
Tired of waiting. Speak. Start talking. You'll tell me everything.
Thank you.
Just doing my duty. Till now, no one suspects I'm working for you. You going?
Yes.
Found out everything, eh?
Yes, Yusuf. The rubidium is now ours forever. George, no!
Thank you. the signal to come and get you.
This is Z1. Come in, G58. This is Z1. Come in, G58.
Jump out, hurry up. They're coming to get
Konnichiwa.
Здравствуйте. Yusuf is dead, but the mission is complete. Please take me away.
My compliments, Captain.
How did he manage not to be recognized in Africa?
He had a very clever rubber mask. I saw him taking it off one day.
Thank you.
from the RIU.